before gracing us with her royal presence as Princess Margaret in The Crown, or Mordra in The Dark Crystal: Age of Resistance, and Eudoria Holmes in Enola Holmes, Helena Bonham Carter had quite the limited acting portfolio. From being in a little-known musical to an obscure book adaptation. Nah, just kidding. She's literally done it all. From the Oscar-nominated performances that the critics love, to cult classics that us nerds obsess over. And to top it all off, she's even played a monkey.
They're not dumb. They can be taught.
You could spend all day digging into her IMDb credits, but we did that for you. Here are the highlights of her career so far. Growing up in London and with her great-grandfather having literally been the Prime Minister, Bonham Carter is as British as it gets. Her first break came in 1983 with the TV movie A Pattern of Roses, where she played Nettie, the privileged niece of a vicar. The film followed the story of a teenager who investigates the rumours of a ghost in his cottage. Arguably, her breakthrough performance came in the Oscar-nominated A Room with a View, where she starred alongside Judi Dench, Daniel Day-Lewis, and Maggie Smith. Helena played the leading role of heroine Lucy Honeychurch, a young Edwardian socialite torn between two lovers. She soon became known for her English rose looks and appeared in a number of period roles like Ophelia in Hamlet.
I give you some violets, but they withered all when my father died.
And Helen Schlegel in Howard's End. But in a bid to shake off the corset typecast, Helena pushed to take on more eccentric roles, such as Marina Oswald in Fatal Deception, Mrs. Lee Harvey Oswald, Elizabeth in Frankenstein,
Elizabeth,
and the high-strung wife Amanda in Woody Allen's Mighty Aphrodite.
You don't know who the boss is between me and Mommy?
No.
I'm the boss, okay? Mommy is only the decision maker.
All this hard work had not gone unnoticed, and she received her first Oscar nomination for her role of Kate in The Wings of the Dove, the story of an impoverished woman forced to choose between her life of privilege or her journalist lover.
I'd be penniless, cast out of society, and I'd be stuck with you.
Good.
Having perfected the art of the period piece, Helena decided to move on to some more contemporary roles, including Jane Hatchard in The Theory of Flight, which was about a paraplegic looking to lose her virginity before she dies. Helena starred alongside her then-partner, Kenneth Branagh, and claims to have drawn upon the experiences of her father, who was wheelchair-bound for years.
Hi.
Hi.
Now for the moment that every film buff has been waiting for. Fight Club.
The first rule of Fight Club is, you do not talk about Fight Club.
Bonham Carter played the now iconic role of Marla Singer, an eccentric support group addict and girlfriend to both Brad Pitt and Edward Norton.
I saw you practicing this.
Practicing what?
Telling me off. Is it going as well as you hoped?
To ensure her character's messy look felt authentic, she insisted her makeup artist apply her makeup using only her left hand. In Novocaine, Helena continued the bad girl theme with the role of Susan, a sexy patient who seduces dentist Steve Martin before stealing all of the drugs from his practice.
Ever date any of your patients?
In the same year, Bonham Carter met her longtime partner and collaborator Tim Burton on the set of Planet of the Apes. She played the role of Ape Ari and went through over 4 hours of makeup a day to achieve the look. This collaboration with Tim Burton continued through the coming years with Big Fish, where she played the roles of both Jenny and the Witch. She also appeared in his adaptation of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory,
time to say it'll be back,
playing Charlie's mother, Mrs. Bucket. In 2005, she played women in the romantic comedy Conversations with Other Women, and she also lent her voice to both The Corpse Bride.
He must have fainted.
And Wallace and Gromit, The Curse of the Were-Rabbit.
Ah, yes. Lady Tottington here, of Tottington Hall.
No British actor's career could be complete without a role in Harry Potter. In 2007, Helena Bonham Carter nabbed the part of the absolutely terrifying Bellatrix Lestrange.
Bellatrix Lestrange?
Neville Longbottom, is it? How's Mum and Dad?
When describing the character in an interview with Entertainment Weekly, she stated, "She's obviously as bonkers as they come. There's a bit of childlike madness there, you know, like boys who like to pick apart an insect for the sake of it." Since she captured Bellatrix's crazy character so well, it was only natural she'd do it again in Tim Burton's Sweeney Todd as Mrs. Lovett, a baker who has some interesting ingredient choices for her pies.
These are probably the worst pies in London.
If all this wasn't evil enough, she then became the face of Skynet in 2009's Terminator Salvation.
Welcome home, Marcus.
Someone has stolen three of my toys!
Fast forward to 2010, and Helena was on board for another one of Tim Burton's adaptations, Alice in Wonderland. Bonham Carter played the role of the Red Queen in this psychedelic trip of a film.
Did you steal my dance?
If one Oscar nomination wasn't enough, Helena struck gold once again in her performance of Queen Elizabeth alongside a stammering Colin Firth in The King's Speech.
My husband has seen everyone. To no avail. Awfully afraid he's given up hope.
He hasn't seen me.
2012 proved to be another killer year for Helena as she starred in three more hits. There was Dark Shadows, her seventh Tim Burton film, where she played the quirky psychiatrist Julia Hoffman.
I might look sweet and innocent, but I have secrets.
Then Great Expectations, where she took on the iconic role of Miss Havisham.
I'm not afraid of a woman who's never seen the sun since you were born.
And last but certainly not least, the award-winning Les Miserables, where she showed off her singing ability once more as the evil innkeeper Madame Thénardier.
Look who's here. The little madame herself.
In order to perfect the role, she even learnt to pickpocket. Next in line for Helena was the role of Red Harrington, the one-legged brothel owner in Disney's Lone Ranger. And a few years later, she returned as the fairy godmother in 2015's live-action remake of Cinderella.
One carriage.
In the same year, Helena also took on the important role of Edith New in Suffragettes. The film was based on the true story of the women who fought for their right to vote in 1912.
You a suffragette, Mrs. Ellen?
I consider myself more of a soldier.
With more girl power to come in 2018, she was part of the all-female reboot of the Oceans franchise, playing Rose Wheel, an Irish fashion designer and member of the heist team. Just when you thought she had done it all, she then went on to be in the new Call of Duty video game where she played a zombie-fighting fortune teller. Yep, it's a bit of a wild card. This takes us up to 2019, where Helena finally made her way onto the top of your Netflix list with her starring role in both The Crown.
The Royal Highness?
No.
Telephone for you?
No.
It's the Queen.
I look hideous.
Coffee?
No, I was thinking whiskey.
And the Dark Crystal Age of Resistance.
Welcome to Hurrah!
So you're probably wondering what could possibly be next for her career. In the meantime, you can catch her in Enola Holmes as the wonderful Eudoria Holmes, the mother to Sherlock, Mycroft, and Enola.
Ah, sorry, Grandpa.
And let us know in the comment section below what your favourite Helena Bonham Carter role was. And don't forget to subscribe for more behind-the-scenes deep dives into your favourite Netflix shows.